what aspirations did you start your career with? What were the challenges you faced and how did you overcome them?
Why did you join Tata Steel, right? So to me, it was, you know, something that you did without thinking too hard about the long term. And I'm being very honest about it. I don't think I joined Tata Steel thinking I would be here today and be with the company all my professional life. But it seemed to be an exciting company to join at that point in time. And basically, I think when you join, you set yourself a few goals at that point in time. I just said, I wanted to, in some sense, be in a manufacturing environment. Aspirations are, it's not that you join a company saying, I want to be the CEO or something. You just join the company because it looks pretty exciting and looks like a good place to join. And then you work your way up.
So out of work, what passions do you follow? And how important do you think it has been in molding your career? Because I can look at you and tell, like, you're a fit person. Like, either you run, you play golf or something.
No, so I think it's very important to pursue or keep connected with things that you enjoy doing, right? And a mistake many people make is to, you know, they have those passions in school and college, and then once you start working, you forget about it, you know, because I feel it's important to develop that, nurture that. That's your go-to spot if you're stressed or if there's something which is not going your way. So for me, it's always been, I mean, sports used to be very important. So something to do with sports, either participating in it or watching it or whatever is very important. Reading is very important. But now given all the reading I do on work-related stuff, I don't have much time for other reading. But again, that's something I do when I have the time and when I need to unwind. Music is a very important part of my life. So different listening to it, playing it, whatever. My family is a very important part of my life. And so I think it's very important to have those, while your work may consume you, you should keep aside time for what you enjoy doing, what relaxes you. I think that's the best way to, you know, unwind and deal with all the ups and downs of life.
So how did you handle the transition of one day being colleagues and next day those colleagues reporting to you? Like, did overnight anyone started calling you sir instead of Naren?
So that's the last part I'm struggling, because I'm very happy being called Naren as long as we all... See, it's not important what people call you. It is more important whether we are all aligned to do what we need to do. It is not that... I think the... If you can accept the fact that people who work with you may know more than you, obviously they would, because they are all experts in their area. You can't be the expert in everything. Your role is to say that, how do I get together a set of capable people to deliver what is right for the organization? It's not that I don't look for personal loyalty. I look for loyalty to the company. It's not that the captain is the best bowler, the best batsman, the best wicketkeeper, best everything. He's best at getting all the good players around and delivering what is best. Sometimes you have a lot of talent in the team, but the captain is still not able to deliver,
like,
right?
RCB. So what message do you have for the young generation where they go through one bad phase or a few months, they start looking for a change? For someone like you who has been in the same organization and grown up the ladder, what message do you have for them?
No, firstly, I think disappointments are a way of life. In fact, to me, who deal with their disappointments and failures better than the others. So don't wallow in self-pity more than required. I think that is my first advice. Second advice is, we are very quick to blame everyone else, blame the system, and not look at ourselves, right?
Even I have done that.
Yeah, so that's natural. It's natural. Don't expect otherwise, but don't overdo it. We don't recognize that. Whenever we get less credit than we deserve, we are very upset. You know, so I think one should reflect and also think that many times I've got more credit than I deserve. Sometimes I get less credit than I deserve, and it balances out. But fundamentally, and that faith you should have in the system, right? So whenever I've had disappointments in Tata Steel, I've believed in Tata Steel.
So now that you are the MD and CEO of Tata Steel, what is next in store for you? What is the next career aspiration that you have?
Oh my God. This is like, I thought this was like coffee with Karan. No, it's Man Ki Baat and Republic TV and everything thrown into one.
No, I'm
privileged to be where I am. I never thought that I will be where I am, right? So now it's time for me to give back, time for me to do whatever I can for Tata Steel and take this great company to even greater heights as with all of you and do what is possible and leave it even stronger for the next 100 years. That's my aspiration. The company is also struggling with what should I do with this guy. So, you know, you're put into some job where you don't have much to do. And I've also gone through those phases in my life. Those are the times when you kind of question yourself. You say, you know, is this the place I want to spend the rest of my career in? But if you have faith, at that point in time also I had faith that yes, I would like to. Maybe I'm going through a period when the company doesn't know what to do with me. But then you can utilize such periods to add value to yourself.